Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hello everyone, my name is Manish Kumar Yadav, and today in this lecture we are going to understand a new topic, that is connective tissues under animal tissues. So first of all, you need to understand that what are the connective tissues. So actually, the connective tissues are the tissues or a group of cells which are responsible for the connection of organs in an organ system. So when we talk about the connective tissues, the origin of connective tissues are the mesodermal origin. So what is mesodermal origin? So during gastrulation is a step of fertilization in human reproduction. So during gastrulation, what happens? The mesoderm, which has been formed from the gastrulation patterning, mesoderm actually are going to be changed into the connective tissues. And the connective tissues is a vast level of connective tissues present in the body of humans. So what are these connective tissues? Connective tissues are most abundant tissues found in the human body. Most abundant tissues in human body. In human body. And there are two components of connective tissues. There are two components of connective tissues. And what are these two components? There are some cells which secrete the fibers. And second one, cells are here which secretes the modified polysaccharides. Cells which secrete modified polysaccharides. So what are these fibers which are going to be secreted from these type of cells, and how the fibers and these type of modified polysaccharides are going to be form a vast of connective tissues? See, there are two things present in the case of connective tissues. First are the fibers and second are the matrix or ground tissues. So modified polysaccharides are actually going to form ground tissue, or it is also known as matrix, which is actually the liquid in which the fibers will be arranged. So fibers are two types, collagen and elastin. So actually in the human body there are three important fibers. First one is collagen, second one is elastin, and third one is keratin. So keratin is actually a protein that is not a fiber, but still we can call that there are three important proteins in human body: collagen, elastin and keratin. Already we have discussed about the keratin in the epithelial region. So now today we are going to discuss about collagen and elastin under the topic of connective tissues. So first of all, we should understand the classification of connective tissues. So let's discuss about the classification. So now in this video, we are going to continue with the classification of connective tissues. Already we have discussed the classification of connective tissues in brief in the introductory portion of animal tissues. But now in this lecture, we are going to discuss in the detail of connective tissues classification. So actually the connective tissues are divided into three basic categories. So connective tissues, we can write it at CT, loose connective CT, that means loose connective tissues. Second one is dense connective tissues, and the third one is specialized connective tissues. So there are three different categories in which we are going to talk in the details. So loose connective tissues, first of all, understand the meaning of loose connective tissues. What is loose in this case? So again, the matrix or the ground tissue is going to be loose. Matrix is loosely arranged. Okay. So if you are going to listen the word loose connective tissues, then you have to remember that matrix or the ground tissues in which the fibers will be present, that is going to be loosely arranged. So here is the condition of loose connective tissues. Then second thing is dense connective tissues, and the meaning of dense connective tissues means matrix is going to be dense. matrix is tensely arranged. And what is arranged in this matrix? The fibers and cells are arranged. Fibers and cells. Then we can also divide this loose connective tissue into two basic categories. First one is areolar, and second one is adipose. So what is areolar connective tissue and what is adipose connective tissue? Areolar connective tissues are present just below the skin, and the adipose tissues are present with the fat deposition, or these are responsible for the storage of fat molecules. So areolar tissues are present below skin, and these are also present below skin, but these are responsible for the fat storage. Second one category is of dense connective tissues, and these dense connective tissues are also divided into two basic categories. First one is regular dense connective tissues, and second one is irregular dense connective tissues. What is going to be regular and irregular in the dense connective tissues? So regular means the fibers and cells present in the matrix region of dense connective tissues are regularly arranged, and in the case of irregular dense connective tissues, these fibers and cells are irregularly arranged. So regular dense connective tissues are of two types. First one is white colored dense connective tissues, regular dense connective tissues, and second one is yellow colored. So white colored is what and yellow colored is what? White colored are fibers, white fibers, and yellow colored are also yellow fibers. White fibers are actually derived from collagen. So one thing which you have to keep in mind, that collagen are white colored. And the other thing, that is elastin. Elastin is yellow colored. So both of the things you have to keep in mind. Then second thing is that white colored fibers which come into the category of regular dense connective tissues, these are actually tendons. And yellow fibers, or also these are derived from the elastin, comes under the category of regular dense connective tissues. These are actually ligaments. So what is the location of tendons and what is the location of ligaments? So tendons are present just between the muscles and bones. So tendons are actually helper or assistants for the attachment of muscles on the bones. And these ligaments are the joints between the bones. So two bones are joined due to the ligaments, and these are yellow colored fibers. And after this, irregular dense connective tissues means the fibers and cells are going to be irregular, and these are actually present below skin. We will be discuss in the detail in the upcoming lecture about it. So below skin, then this portion is completely different and this portion is completely different. Specialized connective tissues are completely different. How these are different, we will be discussing in later on. So specialized connective tissues are also divided into various other categories. So what are these categories? Let's discuss about it. So first and important type of categories in specialized connective tissue is fluid or liquidified specialized connective tissue. And the examples or the categories under this special category, there are two important categories. These are blood and lymph. So if you listen the term blood, the blood are the connective tissues which are devoid of fibers and liquid in nature. Lymph is also comes under the category of fluid or liquefied specialized connective tissues. Then there is second category of skeletal connective tissues. And these skeletal connective tissues are of two basic categories. First one is bone and second one is cartilage. So what are the bones and what are the cartilage, we will be discussing in the later on videos. But here you can understand that bones are also of two types, and these are compact bones and spongy bones. Compact bones and spongy bones. On the basis of its organization and structure, we will be discussing in later on how these are compact, how these are spongy. And cartilage are of three basic types. First one is hyaline cartilage. Second one is fibrous cartilage. And the third one is calcified cartilage. So skeletal connective tissues are of two types, bones and cartilage. Bones are of two types, compact and spongy, on the basis of organization and structure. And cartilages are of three types, hyaline cartilages, fibrous cartilages and calcified cartilages. So three basic categories which comes under these cartilages. Apart from these two basic categories, there are also two categories. First one is reticular connective tissue, and second one is mucoid connective tissues. So here is the complete detailed classification of connective tissues. So apart from these all things, there are some other terms which we also have to understand. First one term is connective tissue proper. So what is this connective tissue proper? So under the connective tissue proper, two things are coming. First one is loose connective tissue and dense connective tissues. So if we can say that connective tissues are basically divided into two basic categories. First one is connective tissue proper, in which the fibers and other cells comes under which. And second one category is of a specialized connective tissues, that is completely different from connective tissue proper. So this is the detailed way of classification of connective tissues. Now let's discuss about the areolar type of tissues. So after understanding the basic classification of connective tissues, now we are going to discuss about the first category of connective tissues, and that is loose connective tissues, where the matrix or ground tissue is loosely arranged. And under this category, first important type is areolar connective tissues. And areolar connective tissues are the tissues which are present just below the skin, and there are three important proteins which are present under this areolar connective tissues. So there are three different proteins present in areolar connective tissues. First one is fibroblast. Second one is macrophages. Third one is mast cells. So three different cells are present under this category of areolar connective tissues, and these three different connective tissues or connective cells are responsible for different immunological responses. When a foreign substance enters in the human body, there are number of immunological responses for the prevention of these foreign substances. These foreign substances, and it may be like a bacteria or a virus. So these are responsible for the defense mechanism of a particular animal or a particular human being. So fibroblasts have two special components. First one is its fibrous content, and second one is matrix. So fibrous content again has two variability. First one is collagen and second one is elastin. So collagen is white colored protein. Collagen is a white colored protein, always present in bundles, and these are unbranched. So three different characters are present in the case of collagen. First one is these are white color. Second one is it's present are in bundles. Third one is these are unbranched. And what are the characteristic features in the case of elastin? These are yellow colored fibers. Second one is always present in the single number And third one is, these are branched. So how the shape is going to be? So if the collagen, the shape will be just like a bundle, like an aggregation of the fibers, and these are actually the collagen. And how is the shape of elastin? Elastin is actually the branch. So there is something like this kind of shape present in the case of elastin. What are these macrophages? Macrophages are actually nothing but phagocytic cells. These are phagocytic cells which are responsible for the engulfing of foreign substances in the human body. And what are the mast cells? Mast cells are very much important. How it is important? So mast cells actually is responsible for the production of three different type of elements. First one is histamine. Second one is serotonin. And the third one is heparin. So what are these things? So let's first discuss about histamine. So histamine is actually a vasodilator. What is vasodilator? A substance which is responsible for the dilation of blood capillaries, so the blood pressure may be decreased. So blood pressure may be decreased from the histamine. And histamine is produced in the allergic reactions. So these are produced from the allergic reactions. And histamine is actually derived from, so what is the precursor of histamine? Histidine. Histidine is an amino acid which is responsible for the conversion of histidine to histamine. So histidine, when the decarboxylation takes place in the histidine, it is going to be converted into histamine, and histamine is a vasodilator. And what is serotonin? Serotonin is a neurotransmitter. It is a neurotransmitter, and it is actually responsible for the happiness. When the number of serotonin decrease, or the concentration of serotonin decrease in human body, so the depression may be arised. So this case you have to keep in mind. Then the third thing, that is heparin. So serotonin has also precursor, and that is tryptophan. Tryptophan is also an amino acid, aromatic amino acid, which converts into serotonin. So serotonin is a neurotransmitter. It is derived from tryptophan. And third thing is heparin. Heparin is actually anticoagulant. So what is anticoagulant? So coagulation is nothing but clotting of blood. So heparin is responsible for the prevention of clotting of blood. So when the heart attack arises in a human body, so there is an injection that is made from this heparin. So heparin can be injected in the case of heart attack. So heart attack can be treated from this heparin injection. So three different things which are produced from these mast cells. So now let's draw the structure of these areolar tissues. That how is the diagram of areolar tissues? So let's try to draw it. So first of all, we are going to draw the ground tissue, or the matrix part of it. So actually I am going to take a section of the areolar tissue. So this is the section of areolar tissue. So here is the matrix or ground tissue. So it is the matrix or ground tissue, and this matrix is derived from the modified polysaccharides. So I'm again going to label it as a matrix. First important cell was fibroblast. So I told that fibroblasts are the cells which are present in the response of fibers, as well as the its protoplasmic extensions. So the shape of a fibroblast is just like this. So this is the shape of a fibroblast. So irregular shape is present in the case of fibroblast. So fibroblast has an irregular shape, and these are actually the protoplasmic extensions, which are long protoplasmic extensions, and a nucleus is present in the center of this fibroblast. So I told that the collagen fibers are actually the white colored portions, or the bundle of fibers. So the collagen fibers will be present just like it. So there is again another fibroblast which we are going to draw. So this is another fibroblast and center in the nucleus. Again the collagen fibers are like this, and these collagen fibers are attached from these fibroblasts. And second thing was the yellowed portion, that was elastin, and elastin was a branched, and these are unbranched. So these are the elastin. So two things have been covered. First one is collagen, second one is elastin in the case of fibroblast. So here is about the fibroblast. Now how is the shape of macrophages? So macrophages are also irregular shaped, and there is also a nucleus. So it is quite different from fibroblast, but it is the macrophage which are responsible for the engulfing of foreign substances which are coming in the human body. So these are macrophages. So I'm again writing again a different macrophage. So this is again a macrophage. Then what about the mast cells? Mast cells are actually the oval shaped cells. So these are mast cells, and mast cells are actually responsible for the production of three different things which we have discussed. So in this way we are going to wind up our today's lecture. In the next lecture we are going to still continue with the connective tissues. So there are a lot of things which we have to learn in this topic. So thank you so much. Thanks for watching this lecture.